Moderation is the key to everything. Yes, everything. It's one of those issues that I almost could bring up when I'm talking about every video I've done at this point. I mean, pretty much every single one of them. I could make a side point about moderation being the key to this angle. When I made my lies aren't always bad video, I talked about how there are certain cases where, like the video is, lies aren't bad. But this is about moderation. Lies can be good if used at the right time. And that is the essence of moderation. The idea that you know when something is appropriate and when it isn't, or when is too much or too little. First, again, with the lies example, telling small white lies is, you know, all right when it comes to does she look fat in that. Like I said, that's a small white lie that causes no harm and it moves things along. However, telling a life-changing, life-threatening lie is dangerous and bad. Moderation lies in between those angles. Or if we're talking about spending money, right? Spending money. You can buy things that you want. You can have flagrant expenditures once in a while, but you can't do that all the time. You have to save some money. You have to hold back from buying everything you want. Or how about, more broadly, just living your life as a totality. Just taking all of the things that are life. Let's apply moderation to that all together, right? One step. Whenever you're doing anything, you can't always be doing that one thing. Whether it's a job, whether it's a love life, whether it's a hobby, anything. If you do it all the time, you'll get sick of it. You'll burn out. You'll go crazy. You can't devote every minute of yourself to one thing. You must branch yourself out. A job, recreation, a love life, friends, time for yourself. All of these things play into a healthy life, and moderation is in each one of these things. How much time you spend for yourself being lazy must be moderated. Because if you spend too little time for yourself, you're going to wear yourself out, run yourself dry. If you spend too little time for everyone else, all the other concerns, just being by yourself, then the rest of your life goes to hell because you're just spending time for yourself. All of the things we do in life are governed by moderation. Everything, from the smallest detail to the largest, most important point. Moderation is involved. We must decide when to apply our fullest effort, when to pull back, when to be passionate, and when to be reserved. And there are times and places for each one of these extremes. And there's a time and a place for the middle road, always. There's times where you don't need to be too extreme, but you need to say something. There are times where you need to stand up, but you don't need to yell. There's a middle path. Very often between two extremes. And even if you have to take an extreme, it should never be the road you always take. There's always a second angle, another route, an option that is not so extreme. And even if there isn't, taking the extreme should be in of itself a moderated thing. Don't do it all the time. And in fact, the final, sort of most difficult to understand concept of this, at least for me, has been moderation itself needs moderation. One of the keys to moderation is there is an exception to every rule, including this one. Sometimes you do have to go balls to the walls, all out, complete effort on something, regardless of the other things going on. Sometimes there is a thing, a task, an object, something that does require that kind of complete and total inhuman sort of effort. Those are the times where even moderation itself must be moderated, and you must take the extra extreme path beyond what would normally be considered moderate or temperate. These are things that are all a part of the mix that is life. Moderation being applied in there helps us go further. It helps us grasp the more total picture of a situation when we moderate our viewpoint. We can't just see things purely from what we think is right. We have to look at the other side to at least, if nothing else, see how to better argue against it. But the better thing would be to see the other side to see what you can understand from it and what you might agree with. Don't be just Camp A man forever. Don't be in Category A no matter what. Look at Category B and C and see if there's a few things you could take from them. Maybe stick with Category A, your group, Republican, or whatever. But take a few things that work from other groups. That's moderation too. Understand that one picture isn't always the total picture. It's usually many things. And part of moderation is looking beyond your own points and seeing that, yes, even my worldview needs to be moderated at times, and I need to look at the universe in a greater perspective. All of it ties together, one package, one neat little whole that helps you move across with life just a little bit easier. Something to think about.